हेलो
यस ओके सो लेट्स
सर, आई
स्टार्ट.
कांट डाउनलोड मंगोडीबी। कैन यू हेल्प मी?
यस दैट इज वी विल स्टार्ट टुडे मंगोडी दैट्स
यस
ओके सो शेयर द स्क्रीन.
यस या माय स्किन इज सर।
Yes, it is visible.
यस
You go to yes, write a MongoDB compass download.
MongoDB।
MongoDB compass download.
कॉम्पस
Yes, compass download.
देन
The
डाउनलोड।
first one. Yes. Then
देन
try
टॉट अप
free.
ट्राई
Try
फ्री।
free. First of all, you need to create the account.
ओके
Yeah, this.
व्हाट कंपनी पीसी स्कूल पर?
यस यू कैन लुक.
यू हैव टू क्रिएट पासवर्ड।
यस फॉर दिस MongoDB अकाउंट वी नीड टू क्रिएट वन पासवर्ड न्यू पासवर्ड एक्चुअली
ओके ओके क्रिएट योर एटलस। यू हैव टू
या
क्रिएट
फॉर
राइट।
Yes, for that Atlas account, you need to give the password.
ओके
Now create. अपना चेक योर ईमेल,
देन
चेक योर ईमेल, ओपन योर ईमेल
ओके
इन अनदर टैब. यस ओपन योर ईमेल. जस्ट वेरी
वेरीफाई।
टाइम.
देन कंटिन्यू।
कंटिन्यू दिस. ओके नाउ विल लीव दिस एंड गो टू द अकाउंट पेज द प्रीवियस पेज.
आई क्लोज इट टू मिनिमाइज।
Minimize this, not close. Minimize this.
देन
At last onboarding, the second one, second. Not
दिस
this one.
वन
No. Second, yes, this one.
दिस वन
Yes. Yeah, just give the go to the Atlas. Click on the Atlas.
दिस वन
वन ये भी करना. And we're not sure until we finish. Just
Open.
open the new tab.
Want to open.
Okay, now give me control. Now we need to just go to the community server. This start select the package, and the current version is this 64 MSN. Yes, you need to download. It is on the let me tell you what is actually MongoDB. It let downloading. So MongoDB basically.
Sir, voice is breaking. Your voice is breaking. Hello.
Yes, now audible.
Yes.
Okay, so MongoDB is basically one database. So this NoSQL database. There are two types of database. One is SQL database and another is non-SQL database. So MongoDB is just like the non-SQL database because here the SQL queries and all are not needed. That's why it is called the non-SQL database. And MongoDB is very scalable, open source, free, and very fast. That's why we use the MongoDB for the React purpose. We can use any purpose, but we can also use the SQL database. But MySQL database, it is very slow and very old technology. But MongoDB is very fast and scalable. That's why you use MongoDB. And it is a document-oriented database because all the document you can create. So it is called MongoDB, the document-oriented database. And it is developed and supported by, it is one kind of company called Tangent. It is actually developed and supported. And now the Tangent name is MongoDB. So MongoDB is one kind of company. So there are some commands are there we can use in the MongoDB shell actually. In MongoDB shell, just like the command line shell we have in Windows, MongoDB has also one shell. Inside the MongoDB shell, we can use the commands just like the Git. We can use commands and we can show the CRUD application. CRUD application means create, read, update, and delete. All the operations we can see inside the MongoDB. Suppose I am creating one collection that is called employee, and inside that employee, we have object ID. We have suppose we have employee name, we have employee ID, we have employee skills. So there are three basic things we can create, read, update, and delete.
Yes.
Okay, I'm showing you. Just stop the screen sharing once. Just one time, stop the screen sharing.
Okay, I'm stopped. Can I
Yes,
stop,
yes, yes,
sir?
yes, 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 yes. Okay, here, this is the MongoDB campus that I have shown you in the previous week.
Yes.
Just on the I send it open. Okay. Okay, now this is the by default port number. So in MySQL we have port number 3306 by default. So that is MongoDB by default port number 27017. That is the by default
Yes.
port number. MongoDB local is 27017. With that port number, we can connect to our front end like React, Express.js. Express.js is your back end, and React is your front end, and MongoDB is your database.
Okay.
So here React is a front, so we can connect this MongoDB with this port number 27017 with the back end and front end. So let's connect this. Okay, so I have database names. These are called the database name.
Okay.
Suppose I have one database PCS one training. And inside that database, if I expand it, we have three collection. One is PCS Global, and there is employee first collection. So let's go to the employee. If I click the employee, see. All is there. Name and role. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are 10 or 11 actually datas are there. All the documents are there. The two parameters is there, name and role. And by default, one object ID is there. This is called the object ID, this ID. When you create one employee information, we insert in the database, one automatically employee ID will be generated, object ID will be generated. So this is the, and this is called collection. In the MySQL database, we call it table, but here actually in MongoDB, we will call it collection. Inside the collect, inside this is the database, and inside the database, this
There
collection.
was the collection. Okay.
Yes.
There are three collection.
Yes. There are three collection. You can go to any collection. This is the first collection. It is the employee. Three collection. You can even create this collection from here also. So here, suppose I'm creating the database. My database name is, suppose, training. Collection name is, suppose, MongoDB. And then create database. See, one training automatically created. And MongoDB database created, but we don't have any data inside the training. One collection will be MongoDB, and we don't have any data inside the MongoDB collection. So we can create the data, or we can also add the data inside. We can add the document ID and SOID. So let's insert this. See, this is the one ID. That will be automatically inserted from MongoDB application. But we will do another way. What is the way? This time showing you. First of all, delete this. And delete this training also. Okay,
Yes,
first of all, you need to this. So this employee, I'm deleting this employee. I need to freshly create this employee. So what can I do? Drop the collection. Okay.
Yes,
The
it's
employee has
deleted.
now I am creating not from here, I am creating it manually. That is the main learning.
Can I recover it? If I mistakenly
No, no,
delete
no.
it.
No, no, no. You cannot recover it. If you have to decide, then you need to leave.
Okay.
So here, I have one document. So in this document, all the comments are there. I am sending you this document. All the comments are there. So first, okay, first of all, MongoDB is properly installed or not? How I check? First, go to the C drive. When you install it, go to program files. And then see, MongoDB one folder will be created. You go to server, go to 5.0, and then go to bin. So we need to open that path in the
So environment, computer environment.
Yeah, first of all, you need to add in the environment variable also. Just first of all, let me see this environment variables, and
yes, then go to path.
Then go to path and edit. After that,
just new,
yes,
then
yeah, new, and then
yes,
you need to
it.
paste that, paste the link. MongoDB server hard 20 bin. When you
Yes.
install this, automatically will generate out. Then you need to copy and paste it.
Yes.
And then OK. And here you don't need to do anything. After doing this, go here. Let's CMD. CMD will open. Yeah, first of all, I write mongo.exe. See, MongoDB shell version 5.0.22. So So I have checked that MongoDB is successfully installed in my system, and the version is 5.0.22.
Yes.
Here I can start my coding. Yeah. This is called the MongoDB shell, mongo.exe. This is called the MongoDB shell, and
Yes.
now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 7 units. I can show it from here also. So you can write show units. See, all the database name is coming here. If you write show DBs, CRUD project, admin config, local MongoDB, PCs monitoring, all things are appear. You can check this. Okay, so what is our next comment? We follow this document. So one by one, we do this document. First of all, we need to go to the this database, and inside this database, we have to create the employee collection. That is our main target. So maybe test. Okay, use this is monitoring. Switch to DB PCS monitoring. Now you can write DB, this is PCS monitoring. So I am coming to this database. From test, I am coming to the PCS monitoring. After that, I need to create one collection that is called employee. So what is the command of that collection? So this is the command of that collection, db.create collection employee. So this is our query. So we have to write this query, db.create collection employee. Create collection. Employee. Db.create collection employee. Yeah, what is the problem? Let me check. Okay. It is case sensitive, so you need to remember that. db.create collection example. Okay. Now OK1 means employee collection will create. Let's check in your database. See, one employee. Created. Understand how to create this collection. Okay, so after that, go to the employee. We don't have any data. So first we create the data. First, we have to create the data. So how we can create the data? We follow the document. So first, we have to insert. First, we have to insert this comment. Okay, db dot write the database name db.employee collection name db.employee dot insert one. Insert one. and after that name it should be suppose this is the name. And it should be the role. And role should be suppose I am writing engineer. Okay, understood. You need to give the inverted commas. It is very case sensitive, so you need to care about them. Okay, so no acknowledge true means first data will be inserted. Let's refresh this. See, data will automatically come. Pallavi and engineer. And the object ID will be automatically generated, automatically created. One object
Yes.
ID. Next, add another one. So, I will insert one.
Yes. We can add everything in.
Yes, I can add a number of variables.
Yes.
Suppose I am adding.
Can we add list of number in this format? List of name like name and their list of name and their roll numbers and their occupation, everything, role like.
Role means job role. Yes,
Oh,
yes, we
yes.
can. Yes, the role actually it will be there, and we can add another thing. Another parameter we can add. Suppose.
No, no, I want to insert a number of people. You can understand. Are you understand my question?
Number of people means I don't understand. Again, tell me.
Actually, I want to add in this list, I want to add number of people and their role and everything.
Yes, you can add
Only.
any number of people.
Okay.
There is no issue. You can add any number of people. So
So
name
we
role.
can't add a multiple number. We don't care.
Yes, we can add multiple number of people, no matter. Yeah, just we add one. We can add multiple number of people. It is maybe it is 10, maybe it is 20, 100, no matter what.
Okay.
Say name role and here just giving the name. Just writing this. Okay, so let's check. It's come. Okay. So this is insert. So we have done the insert one. Now we will do the update one. We will do the update one. So for the update one, what query we need to be write? db.employee, that is the collection dot update one. First of all, we write insert one. So now we write update one. Update one name, whatever the name. So which name we need to update? It is the name. It may be holocaller, it may be Pallavi. Whatever I have two names, one is Pallavi and another is holocaller. Two names I have. So I need to, so which role or anything I need to update. So first of all I give the proper name. Name and then set. And after that, whatever the role I need to update. So let's take this query and write here. So here I need to change because I don't have any name like baby. We have other names. Okay, Pallavi. So the name, and I need to set the I have to change the role from engineer to suppose junior software engineer. Then enter. Okay, acknowledge true, modified count one. So I need to just add one, change one thing. So that's why it is called one. Let's check it is changed or not. So this will be changed. See, this will be changed. Every time you refresh this, the data will be accordingly will change. So this is called the update. This is called the update. Okay, next. Okay, now I okay, so next command is what? Next command is db.mpeg update mini. Update mini means suppose I have update one person information, and update mini means I need to update two employee or three employee information at a time. That's why we need to just write update mini. That you need to remember. Update, when you want update one and when you need update mini, that you need to remember. Update one means you need to add just one employee. You need to update one employee, and update mini means you need to update two or more employees. So let's take this example. Let's take this query. And right here, and I need to change this. Suppose it should be on a file. Well, the name should be same, otherwise it cannot find from the database. Okay, from Olokandra, I need to change the names, name and role both. You can write Priyanka, and role should be engineer. Okay, so db.imperator update mini, then name this one, and then what I need to set name. These two parameters I need to change, name and role, then enter. Let's check. See, Priyanka engineer. It is called update mini. So rather than one parameter I need to change, I need to change two parameters or three parameters at a time. That is called update mini. That is called the update mini. Okay, now move to the next query. After done all the query, you can go to your system and then install the MongoDB. Okay, now the next query is insert. Insert means previously we have insert one employee, Now we need to insert another entry. Another three entry. One, two, and three. Three entry that we need to insert at a time. So that's why we need to write insert. So if you add one employee, then you need to insert one. And if you add two or more employees, then you need to write insert. That is a very, very basic difference in the insert query. Okay, let's take this query. Okay, the role engineer it will be fine. Name should be and this role should be suppose a chat. And it should be suppose Julie and role should be engineer. And we can add another person. Name here should be Nikal and role should be this market. Okay, so we need to create a four employee. One is Devu, another is Samarth, Julie Das, and Deepak. Four names I need to create in our database.
Yes.
Okay, and I need to check by one instead. Right, result one. Okay, one minute. Okay, so in that case, we need to add one by one, I think. Let's check on screen. These queries should work actually. Now it will actually be inserted one at a time. So it will insert one at a time. One minute. is administered cannot return. Okay. So we need to clear one by one. We'll clear that. Let's delete this. Let's add another one. Insert one. Somewhere. No. Chat. Okay. It will add it. Yes, another one. Marketing service. Okay, so the data is coming. Okay, next. Okay, again the update on. Already showed you what is the update on. Let's check again what is the update on. Update one means. The update on. Actually, we need to change the name. Let's go to settings. Need to give the proper name, otherwise, it cannot work. Submit. Like. Then roll. Age council. Modified. So what my age happens. Okay, now next is find one. Find one means suppose you need to find any data here. Any information you need to find. That means the populate, that is called populate. If you populate the data, then that is the query db.employee.findOne. db.employee.findOne, then name. Whatever the name you can find, right? And then all the information actually you can give here. So let's check db dot find on. Name. the information is coming. Name and role information is coming, automatically the ID will be coming. Now another is find. We will do find one. Now we will do find. And then we need to write dot pt. This is the one kind of method, pt method. So let's check. Taking this query. Whatever the role is engineer, that will come with the find. The object ID name will engineer. So whatever the engineer is there, so one engineer, the way it will come. And dot pt. If you just write here dot pt, then what will happen? And dot pt. Actually, it will come in the ptr format. It will come in the ptr format. Okay. We can find also name db dot name dot find. Name suppose nameless. Name should be right. It should be nameless. Julie Jazz is gonna find and dot pt. It is coming in the ptr format. So this is the find one, that means the populator. Now again the insert on, update on you. See, now let's see the delete, the last one. We will do insert, update, populate, and the last one is delete. So the same query is called delete. So let's write the query. We dot employee dot delete one. Give the name. Which name? Suppose I am deleting. Not nine. Deleted count one. Okay. So let's check it is deleted or not. Some will be deleted from the database. We can manually delete from here also. Or you can automatically delete, and you can delete from here manually. Okay. It's this is the final. Okay, another last is divided input insert menu. It's called the insert menu. And previous some time ago, just I have created one by one. Now we will do the insert menu at a time. So I will have Amduri. Then Torunil. Nandesh Sanjeev Ramakant. Also Python development. Name the okay. So three object ID already created. So three person actually added in our database. Abdul, Sonil, and Ramakant. Three person will be added. So just write the query and then you can add all the data, delete the data, populate the data, and update the data. That is the main thing of the MongoDB. Inside the employee collection and inside the business monitoring database. And from here also, you can update here also. You can update, you can delete, you can export the data, export query results, or export the full collection. If I give someone that database, you can export the full collection. So all the employee collection you can give to it another person. And add data, you can add the data from here. Import JSON or CSV file, or you can import document. Just like we import document, just like we are added here in the document format. We have added all the information in the document format, and that's why the MongoDB is called the document-oriented database. Okay, and I'm stop sharing. Then you share.
Hello.
Yes, now share the screen.
Yes.
Let's complete the installation.
Yes, it completed.
Okay, now go to the downloads.
Yes, open.
Yes, open.
Next.
Next. Accept the terms and conditions. Then next,
It's
complete, complete.
then
Then no need to do anything. That's next. Next,
next install.
install. Yes, install.
Sir, now 6:30 PM, there was a project meet in Python, a data analytics project.
Okay, no problem.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so your project meeting is taken by Ramakant, sir.
Yes.
Okay. I think Python is taking the Ramakant and Solonin, right?
Yes, Soronil sir is taking Ramaka Python class.
Okay. They are in the Python department.
Yes, sir.
Yes, they are in the Python department.
Yes. Sir, other people, why they don't join among
Actually, I'm already giving the link, and three people actually need to join, but they are telling that one person has some problem, that's why he cannot join. He's saying me actually.
Yes, sir. Sir, more people in Mon, no, that's why
Yes,
I'm
yes,
asking.
yes, yes. You know, there are actually 73 people in the morning. In the group
Yes.
actually, but all people are not in the MUN. They are all maybe some in Java, maybe some in Python.
They all keep the name in Mon, so that's why Madam putting him in them name in Mon group.
Okay.
Yeah, it's taking time.
Yes. Finish this.
Then start.
Yeah, finish this.
Then
Then
start.
start.
Then.
Yes. This is your by default local host, 2017. You don't connect now. Just minimize this. First of all, we need to set the path variables.
Okay.
Go to the environment variables. Edit environment variables.
Then
Go to path. Yes, this path.
upper.
Yes, upper path. Now edit. No, edit. Cancel, cancel. Edit. 1 minute. One is in the list is coming. Okay, just create the new. Click new. Click new.
Then what to do, sir?
Okay, 1 minute. No, 1 minute. Yeah, actually my path is there. I think that's new path variable link 1 minute. I am checking. Just write NV. Okay.
What to write, sir?
Variable name. Just write MongoDB. Value should be. I am giving one link in the chat box, just copy and paste them.
Then what to do?
I am giving one link, then you can just paste the link here.
Okay.
One minute, I am giving the link. This one. Just copy this and paste in the variable value.
Okay.
And
Yes, then
inside the
okay.
data, no. Inside data, just instead of data, just write in bin.
What, right?
Bin, BIN, bin. Instead
Been.
of data, just write bin. Yes, now okay.
Okay.
Then okay.
Then what to do?
The program files. Go to program files. Not here, not in the my computer.
Okay.
Program files, MongoDB.
Open it.
click on this.
Then.
Click MongoDB.
Okay,
Yes, go to
then now.
server. Go to 5.7.0, yes. After that, bean. Okay, now, okay, one second. Give me control. One minute. Actually, I am not controlling your system. That's the problem. Not working actually.
Okay.
Okay, just I am giving the link that you need to write here in the chat box. Just wait, I am giving the link. Just try here, mongodb.exe. Let's check.
What to write, sir?
Yeah, right here, mongodb.exe.
OTP.
Dot
Then
exe.
E is
Exe. Exe.
EX.
Yes, EXE.
Then
EXE, not
enter.
P, EXE. EE.
EXE.
Yes. Enter.
Enter.
MongoDB is going to be launched. Why it is coming in your system? Let's need to check. Not working. Okay, no problem. Let's check. That link I am given to you in the chat box, just paste it first of all. Now paste here.
Okay, which one? This for you
Yes, in
given.
C program files MongoDB servers build that link just paste here. Yes, it's here. Just try click and paste. Okay. Okay, now
Enter.
give me now give me control.
Yes.
Okay. That's nice.
Why it is failing?
That is the main problem. CD is dot dot slash on it. again delete this and again open that terminal.
Again.
Delete this and delete the whole terminal. No, delete the whole terminal. Cross, right click in the right hand side, cross.
Wait, right.
Just delete the whole terminal. Just delete the PowerShell. Close the PowerShell. Not this one. This one. This one. This one.
Actually, I can't close. Okay. Yes.
Yeah, this one. You can go to that folder, that MongoDB folder. Actually, I'm not taking control of your system because and I think network is really slow. Go to MongoDB, go to server 7.0 bin. Yes, now right click on the white space. Right click. No, right click. Just
Actually,
right click.
okay.
No, not there. Down in the white space.
What?
Down in the white space. Yes, just right click. Not there. Opening, not there. Yes.
This one?
No, you can give me.
Okay.
Yeah, and paste this link again. Okay. Now again, give me control. Okay. Give me again control. Paste this here again. Okay. Meeting to 7.0. Yes. Actually, it is coming here. It is not coming yet. I don't understand. Okay, that is the problem, I think. You need to restart your laptop. I think we need to set the path in environment variables, and then you need to restart the laptop. Just 1 minute.
Sir, okay, sir. I will try because it's 6:25. I have to go. I will try myself.
No, need to try. I'm just then little more taking time. Just 1 minute. Okay, just give me again. Okay, you need to restart your system. That's it. Can you quickly restart?
Yes.
Okay, then restart the system, then just quickly join. Otherwise, we will see the next day.
I have to stop scale, sir, screen.
Yes. You just once stop the screen sharing and again quickly join again. Rejoin after the restart. Okay, now share the screen. Okay, now share the screen. Give me control again. Yeah, just open the. Okay, just. See it. Paste this here. Okay, 1 minute. I am giving again. Paste this again. Okay. Recognized as the name of function script file. Okay, I think we need to again reinstall the MongoDB, I think. Maybe this. That's why the problem will happen. Yeah, go to yes. We starting. How is the downloads? Where is the setup file? One minute. Yeah, go to the setup file. No, not here. That executable, that installation file. Where you can down, where you download that file. From the browser. No, not this one, not this one. I mean the link that maybe it should, yeah. It's not there. How is this possible? Okay, it's already 6:30, right? 6:35. Okay, Pallavi, it is all there. That's why it is already 6:35. You need to join another session, right? Hello. Hello. Pallavi, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, can I leave?
Yes, you can leave because this is we can see in the next day.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.